Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for April to June 2015. The past month has seen dry conditions, heat and tropical cyclones. Plus we've moved to El Nino watch. But first, let's look at recent conditions. March so far has been dry in many areas, with an extended break in the northern monsoon. Most areas with above average rainfall were heavily influenced by cyclone activity. Tropical cyclone Olwen in Western Australia brought up to four times the average March rainfall, and it also destroyed some crops. Likewise, tropical cyclone Nathan brought rain to far north Queensland in two separate bursts. Severe tropical cyclone Pam caused devastation in the central South Pacific, particularly when it crossed Vanuatu at Category 5, the highest on our scale. Pam was so intense and brought such violent seas that satellite data clearly show its cool wake in the ocean. Northern Australia experienced heatwave conditions in March as the usual wet season cloud and rain stayed away. Birdsville in Queensland recorded 46.5 degrees on the 19th, the hottest temperature ever recorded in Australia in the second half of March. Three drier than usual northern wet seasons since 2012 mean long-term rainfall deficiencies now cover large parts of inland Queensland. Low rainfall and soil moisture in recent months mean water storage levels in many key areas have fallen considerably since this time last year. Looking ahead, let's see what may drive Australia's climate in the coming months. With higher than average sea surface temperatures in the tropical Pacific Ocean and models suggesting further warming, our ENSO tracker has moved to El Nino watch. This means there's about a 50% chance of an El Nino in 2015. That's double the normal likelihood. El Nino generally means an increased chance of a drier than usual winter and spring for northern and eastern Australia. However, El Nino isn't the only story. Indian Ocean sea surface temperatures are very high and may well influence our climate leading into winter by feeding more moisture over inland Australia. Turning now to the April to June rainfall outlook. With El Nino unlikely before winter, this outlook is heavily influenced by the warmer Indian Ocean. Wetter than average conditions are likely across much of Australia. We've added 27 locations to our seasonal Streamflow forecast service, which means we now have sites in all mainland states and territories. More locations will be included in the coming months. Streamflow forecasts to the end of May indicate lower than usual flows are likely at 32 of 63 locations. Median flows are forecast at 19 locations, with high flows likely at 12. Accuracy for these streamflow forecasts is moderate at this time of year. Turning to temperature, the outlooks favour warmer days in many areas, especially across northern and southern Australia. Warm nights are very likely. Accuracy for these outlooks is moderate to high at this time of year. Although we're approaching the end of the northern wet season, cyclones are still possible. So in summary, a warmer than normal April to June is likely. Odds favour wetter conditions during the next 3 months due to a warm Indian Ocean. Low to median streamflows more likely, and an El Nino watch, indicating at least double the normal odds of an El Nino in the second half of 2015. For more details, head to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 23rd of April. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Feikema.